Hello watcher and subscriber, today we will see the use of next method in the thread class, that is the sleep method. So sleep method of thread class is used to sleep the thread for specific amount of time when it is in running stage. So in this way you can see here you can use the sleep method in the program. Suppose the thread is running and you are using sleep method, then it will convert into sleeping stage. Means current execution of thread will go into the sleeping state so that the other thread will get chance for running. So in such a way we use the sleep method. For example, in for loop you want to show value 1 to 10, okay, and if you use condition I equal to 3, then method should sleep, then that particular thread should sleep. So what happen once it is I equal to 3, then it will give chance to other thread for the execution. Then after that turn again, after the completion of 1000 milliseconds, that current thread, whichever the method, use the sleep method, that thread will get chance for the execution. So here in short what happened in the running stage, if you use sleep method, it will give chance to other thread for the execution. So you can use the sleep method like this in the program. So now we will go in the Eclipse and we see one sample program. There we have the sleep method, so that you will not face any problem for the use of sleep method. So friend, here in this program I will take one thread. So this is my thread, and then you can say this is the thread class and you have to use run method. And here I am taking one statement, and then I will take one loop for showing some values. So this is the for loop which will show some values. So I just copy that statement and here it will show the values of I. And this code we will copy for creating the next thread. And we will just change the name and I also change the variable also for avoiding any confusion. Here by mistake I written 1, it's I. So here our code is completed. We have created two thread. So first we will run the program without sleep method so that you will understand the value of sleep. So here as usual you have to create object of class. So here I am creating object of class, first is A1. Same you do for the next one. So we have created two objects and finally we run. So now as you right now we don't have the sleep method in the program. We have just created two threads for showing value 1 to 10 and we will check output. Now you can observe here they will run simultaneously. Sometime the output will come from A1, sometime B1. You already aware about this. So for avoiding this we will use sleep method in program. So if I exactly 3, then in such a case I would like to put sleep method in the program. So whenever friend you use the sleep method in the program, you have to enclose in the try and catch block. So here I am using the brackets, and here I will take try block. In that try block I will take sleep method, and here the timing is 1000 milliseconds, and which is followed by catch block. So here our case is, if it is 3, it will run the sleep method. So whenever you use sleep method, you have to use try and catch block in the program. So now we will check output. And now you observe, initially they will run simultaneously. So here I is 1, I is here 2, and once I equals to 3, then in such a case you observe the J is continuously execute, because here I is 1, I is 2, and our condition was if I is 3 then it will give chance to other. Okay, so it will show only I is 1 and I is 2 value. So you observe here J is running for 1000 milliseconds. So it is giving more chance to next thread, and the timing for that 1000 milliseconds, that is sufficient. Then it will come on I, and I will start the remaining execution. You observe here. So in this way your thread will work out. Here I will show you thread one more time if you have any confusion. In the run method we use the for loop, and our case is if I is 3, then it should sleep and give chance to other. That's why in the output we got the value I is 1 and 2, and then rest of the output came from the thread B1, which was showing some values. So I hope friend you understood this tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.